Namaste, welcome to my home kitchen. I'm Bhavna and today I'm going to show you another type of roti very popular among kids. Yes, not just kids but the grown-ups also love this roti. I was inspired to make this roti because I want my kids to eat roti, but every time they will say, oh, again roti today, and I don't want to hear that. Instead, I would rather like to see them excited. So sometimes I tell them, oh, today I'm making ball babi. So what ball babi means is a puff puris, and they get so excited. And this roti is a, sometimes I make it triangle, and so I tell them, oh, today I'm making triangle babis, and then they call actually babi to roti. So they will get again excited. Oh yeah, triangle babis. So all right, so today I'm going to show you that how we prepare that roti. So here I have the 1.5 cup of whole wheat flour, or the chapati flour you can buy from the Indian grocers. And just a few ingredients. I have here the oil, water, and salt. So let's first make the dough. Here into the bowl, in the wheat flour, I'm going to add, it's gehu ka atta. I'm going to add salt, namak. You can adjust to your taste, but for 1.5 cup, I almost add about 1/2 teaspoon of salt. And to this now I'm going to, actually first I have to mix the dry ingredients. So mix the salt and flour very well. And now here I have the oil. I'm going to add about 4 to 5 tablespoons of oil. Yes, we do need that because I want to make nice rotis. So I usually add for 1.5 cup about 4 to 5 tablespoons.
I'm just going to eyeball. I'm very good at eyeballing. So mix.
And now knead the dough with the water. Just regular.
Add water slowly and make nice dough. Not too hard, not too soft. About semi-soft. Just like you prepare the roti atta, chapati dough. But I usually normally keep a little bit harder than the chapati dough. So I'll show you exactly what type of dough you need.
So the dough is ready, and as I said, just like a roti dough but just a little bit harder than the roti dough. So very similar to the roti dough, but here is how you want your dough. Now I'm going to cover it. So I'm going to cover it and let it sit on a counter for at least 15-20 minutes. The dough has been resting for about 15-20 minutes now, and I'm ready to roll. So what I'm going to do is, before I start rolling, I'm going to smooth out this dough with the clarified butter. You can simply use butter or oil or anything that you would like to. So just a little bit. So here is how the dough is. Look at that. And just add a little bit of ghee and it will become more smooth. Alright, so I'm going to take little bit bigger than golf size of ball, and then couple of times with your fist do like this, and then flatten it out just like that, and keep this dough covered while you're working so it doesn't get dry. Alright, so this I'm going to dust into the flour. I have here the all-purpose flour. So dust and roll about halfway, about 2 inches diameter, or more, about 3 to 3 diameter. And here is what comes the part, and here is what I do. I take the ghee and spread the ghee. You can use oil, spread oil a little bit, but ghee gives a nice flavor. And on the top, sprinkle the flour, all-purpose flour or the wheat flour, anything that you like you can use, but I'm using this simply all-purpose flour. And then fold in half and again fold in so it gets like a triangle. Now you have to keep this triangle. So make sure that you roll. Again, I'm going to dust a little bit and roll. You're gonna just roll like this, straight. And you can move this way and then again, but try to keep it triangle shape.
like that. So your triangle chapati or roti is ready.
So I have rolled already
two rotis already.
Now there are two ways you can bake these rotis, and I'm going to show you both ways. I have already posted the recipe for how to make the roti, the regular everyday roti chapati, the puff chapatis, and the bakri as well. So exactly the same way I bake these rotis. The first one is going to be just exactly like I make the rotis, the regular everyday roti. And the second one is going to be just like I make the bakri, I bake my bakris. So let's bake.
So here is how I do. I preheat my tawa first. Now my tawa is already preheated. My tawa is already hot. So what I do, I bring down my rack. Because I'm using the ceramic stove, I need the rack. Otherwise, as soon as I place the roti on here to puff it up, it stick to the stove. So I need this rack. And by the way, this rack is very hard to find. You can try to find at the Indian grocers. And I got this from India. So, but you can use anything. If you can find the cooling rack, the cake cooling rack, you can turn that cake cooling rack into the rack for this, particularly for this roti. So anything that you can find sturdy, that rack, any kind of rack you can find, you can use that. So I have the already ready, and I'm ready to bake my rotis here. So the first one, as I said, I'm going to just bake it just exactly like the same way I bake my rotis. So the tawa is already ready, and my roti is ready to go onto the tawa. When you see the bubble like this, turn the other side, just like that. And remember that my temperature is right now it's on a medium heat. So as soon as you place the roti, you can bring down the temperature on a medium heat once your tawa is just hot enough. And make sure that it's not too hot. Otherwise, as soon as you put the roti on, it will kind of burn right away and it won't bake properly. So you want to get kind of a medium heated tawa. And you can see that it's again puffing up. And let's check on the other side, it's almost done. So take this tawa and directly bring it onto the rack, just like that. Now this roti, it doesn't puff like the puff roti that I earlier showed the video, but I still try to do this that way so that it again bake directly onto the stove. And because the steam is coming out, that's why it doesn't puff up. And we have made the layered roti, so that's why it doesn't puff off like the regular roti. Now for the other type of baking roti, I have here the tawa. I'm using this tawa, and I'm going to heat up this tawa and keep the temperature on a low to medium heat. So the tawa is warm enough, so I'm going to place this roti. And now you will need a spatula. Earlier we used a tong like this to flip. Now this one, we need this spatula. When you see the bubble like this, turn on this side. This one puffed now, look at that. So some of the rotis will puff, some might not. Look at this, now the air is coming out, so it again sits down. So if you press on this crack, then it will puff again, look at that. Let's see on the other side. Already done. Now here is what I do for this one. I smear a few drops of oil and bake with the oil a little bit, just like I do my bakris. I have already posted the video exactly the same way. So what you're gonna do is keep flipping a couple of times so that the oil is coated all over. So bake till you get the little golden brown color. And look at this, it looks nice. And I love this roti versus that other baked without oil. I like this one better. Look at that.
But that's my personal choice. But if you want low fat or fat free bread, flatbread or something, then you can just bake without even oil. And you can also reduce the amount of oil when you make the dough. And you can, instead of spreading the ghee clarified butter, you can use the low fat margarine or fat free margarine or oil, anything that you can think of. All we need is just a moisture. So this bread, these rotis, comes out nice, soft, that you can eat with any curry. We usually make these rotis when I prepare any kind of lentil curries. So my kids love these rotis with any kind of lentils, and especially when I make the curried lentils. And today I have actually my dal fry that I'm going to eat this roti with. I'm going to give it a bite, and let me show you how soft these rotis are. This roti comes out so soft, you can just torn apart just like that, and look at these layers inside. The dal is amazingly delicious. I can't tell you how good it is. You have to give it a try. So this was all about the triangle rotis. Thank you for watching, and I will see you real soon with the next great recipe.